Hey again. You are seeing double, so don't freak out. I've actually got, I'm hosting the Zoom, and then I've got myself in as a participant from my phone joining the Zoom, which you can do too if you want to set up a two-camera shoot. It's kind of interesting. But what I wanted to show you was how to record your Zoom. Now, this should be available through Zoom Pro. I'm not necessarily sure if it's through Zoom Free, the free version of it, but you can do this through Pro. Here's why it's helpful is because not only maybe you want to record a webinar or a training or a gathering you need to share with someone later who might be absent or who really needs the material, or you're going to do it over and over and you'd rather have something rather than just doing it over and over. Maybe you can just record one session of it and then have that to repurpose. But another reason you may want to record is attendance and interactivity. So record in Zoom is actually really great. It doesn't just record the video. So let me show you what I'm talking about. So let's say I'm going to go open Manage Participants, and I'm also going to open the chat window. So notice I can get all of that in one on the side, and I can kind of keep track. Again, I see myself as the co-host and stuff. So let's say that I'm going to hit record. Now, when recording starts, now we've got a little indicator up here saying it's recording. Also, every participant, including yourself in the Zoom, will get a little audible computer voice in their ear saying this meeting is now being recorded. They will also get it for anyone who's joining the meeting will immediately hear that first. It is just a warning to people, which makes sense. In some countries and states, there are laws around recording someone without their permission, but that way it lets people know they're being recorded. Also notice there's a recording cloud thing going on over in the participants. Everyone's being recorded, and that means all their interactivity, not just in the chat, in the call itself, but in the chat as well. So here's what's great. Let's say that I want to say, hey, everyone, to help us take attendance, can everyone please put your name in the chat? Mm-hmm. And so what they can do is say, okay, yep, Rachel Moore, I'm here. And like JoJo Smith is here. And so again, all of these people, I'm actually typing the names in. But what you'll see is that Joe Smith will put Joe Smith, Rachel Moore will put Rachel Moore, John Doe will put John Doe, and so on, and Jane Doe as well. So what's great is that when you record, not only will you get the recording of the video, but you'll also get the recording of the chat. So you'll get a note or a simple text document of everything that occurs in the chat after you hit record. So if you are taking attendance and don't have the means right during the call to be marking people down, just record it, have everyone do their attendance, and you might have to remind them a couple times in case anyone comes in late. But that's how you're going to mark attendance, because later you can go look at the recorded chat, which is all text, and you can see which names did I gather after I took attendance. You can also gather, it's great because sometimes people are going to put stuff in chat that's a link or it's something helpful for everyone, a resource on the call. You will have that because remember, once you quit Zoom, quit this meeting, that chat goes away unless you've recorded it. So I'm a huge fan of recording. The additional thing that's great about Zoom is we live in a day and age where people probably want to get a transcript or even do some captioning of videos. I'm not sure where your video is going to go of the recorded Zoom. You just never know. What it will also do, it'll record the text of the chat. It'll record the video of your call, but it's also going to try to transcribe it. It'll record a transcription of every word that was uttered on the Zoom audibly. Now, it's not perfect. It's a lot like some other transcription services that are online. It will absolutely have errors. There'll be some autocorrects in there where if someone doesn't say something clearly, it's going to assume something else. But I would say probably about 80% accurate for the wealth of what spoken words are uttered in the call. So if you need to be tracking stuff like that with your Zooms, recording is a great option. Remember, you can also pause recording if you get to a point where you're like, hey, we need to stop recording, kind of talk off the record right now and pick it back up again. So recording's a fabulous option in case you need to do some of those other things like take attendance or get a transcript of whatever was said, and maybe even repurpose your call that has visuals in it for something else. So do remember that you have recording at your beck and call in Zoom calls. I hope this was helpful and enjoy the rest of our how-tos.